It started with me, though, with addiction. So I guess I'll pull it back where I had a lot of things happen as a child as far as like abuse, trauma, different types of abuses as well. So I think that's why, you know, I went in the drug route, because it did help with me to numb any sort of pain that I was feeling. It made me feel like I could live normal with all the abuse. And I know that's, you know, drugs for me was that. It did increase. It got worse and worse and worse. And then with that, becoming a drug addict, life becomes worse and things just compound. And it got to a point when I was 28 years old where I just decided that I no longer wanted to be here, because what was the point of another day of just suffering? Because every day was just another day of hell. A year prior, my brother died too. So I know that was really the starting point of what kicked it off for me. Like that put the fuel on the fire of my pain. And it wasn't, it was about 1 year after that I decided that I would end my life. I did this with pills, and I was really sure that I was going to die. So I knew what I was doing was going to kill me. I just was not expecting to not be killed. Although I was killed, yes, of course, I wasn't expecting an NDE and then coming back. And I took the pills. Everything just kind of went dark on me, as in it was like just darkness was fading in on me. I can't really, it's hard to describe, but like you're dialing down, you know, the light thing, and then it just like starts to get like darker and darker and darker until it's completely black. So it like dimmed until it was black. And I know it was about 15 minutes or so where I lost complete. So I have no clue what happened in that time. But then all of a sudden light started to come in, and that's when I was hovering above my body in an ambulance. So I was like still within the ambulance, but on like more of the roof of the ambulance. There was paramedics over top of me, and they were saying, they were talking, and there was a lot of stuff going on, but I was looking down at my body, and I remember really vividly, I knew I was dead, but then it was so automatic to how alive I felt. That was like really shocking for me. Yes, I'm dead, but I'm alive, but I'm more alive than I was when I was alive. So I knew that being dead was actually more where like we're actually alive. I know that seems weird or whatever, but that's what it felt. And then slowly I began to see things kind of like were foggy, but time and space didn't really work the way it did when I was alive. And I think the first thing that I really went through was almost like a review, I guess. We say like we get a review. It wasn't like a review, like you're watching something, although it kind of was, but I was more like feeling what I was watching than watching it. So I noticed that all things exist in one moment, and that were just perceptions of that one moment. And it was clear that this life is a purpose of growth. So all the lessons and all the things that we went through, their meaning for it was for growth. But ultimately, the meaning of life, though, was not necessarily life's meaning, but our own meaning that we put on our own experiences. And then everything just started to kind of now flash as far as my experiences, as far as like certain events or people. And there were people that I hurt, people that I affected in negative ways. I felt all their pain. I felt what they felt. I felt their anger towards me. But I also felt people that actually I did affect in positive ways. I felt their love for me, their care. I felt things all around me as if it was all me, but it was all very separate at the same time. Once again, time and space too seemed very at one point, but yet I was seeing like past lives, but also future stuff as well. So everything's kind of like connected out. So after kind of having this review as far as what I, you know, did or didn't do, or the fact that, you know, life was a series of challenges, I noticed right away that there's different bodies to us. So we're not just a physical body, we're obviously an energetic body. So I'm the energetic body, which is the real me, which the physical body is just like a vessel that I experience this reality in, but it's just a time frame. It's not obviously forever. It's just a blip of an experience that we experience this for. And then we have an emotional body, and that body comes to me like it's like a blanket. It either carries a lot of weight or not. It's very electrical as well. And then we have a mental body too, where all our beliefs, our definitions of things, our thought processes, everything that, you know, mentally going on, our traumas live in the mind. And that to me has had a separate energetic form. So it was very clear that we're not just one body, we're multiple bodies that all come together at once. And we have to be able to work on each body to affect the other body. So it all comes together, although we need to be able to work on those bodies in order to lighten the load. So after this, my brother who passed away a year prior had come up to me, just started kind of coming in from the side. And he came up to me, and it was just like him. So nothing had changed other than the fact that he was healthy. He was happy. He was vibrant. He reminded me of himself when he was young before he started using drugs and stuff. He was just his bubbly self as far as making light of the situation. From there, my brother wanted me to follow him. He took me to this giant room. It was all just like a big circular white room. It was just bright as hell. And I then was waiting there. And then there's these three beings that I was introduced to. They were from different time eras as well. The whole message from these beings that are like spirit guides or whatever you want to call them, which I think are spirit guides, but the whole message was that you're not done. There's a certain job for you. There was a reason why you came, and it's not just to hang out and kind of have a life and get through, but you have a job, like a purpose, like a bigger purpose than what you would think you would have. And so it was obvious that I needed to go back, and it was so easy to make the decision to go back though too from there, even though when I went back, it was horrible. And then from there, the room that was all bright started to light up and became like a holographic projection, and it was surrounding me. And from there, I got to see my future. So when people say like the future of future Earth, I'd say it's my future Earth, if you will. And I saw where I would live. I saw what I'd be doing. I saw the air, how fresh it was, how clean. Everything seemed different. Like the world was changed in a big way, because that world, what I saw, just couldn't exist without the world going through a radical change. So I have a big belief in that we are heading to some great change, whatever that looks like. I don't know, but I guess we'll have to all ride that together. From there, it was more or less like, you're going to go back now. You know, I decide to go back. I come back, because this is when it kind of gets a little crazy too. So I come back and I find myself in a hospital bed, and it's all bright, and it was like horrible. So all the pain in my body, in my mind, in my, like all that pain that I left came all back. And so I had a real big contrast from the pain to the not pain. And then everything was bright, and the doctor's voice was so goddamn loud. I remember being like, just really like messed up about it. Like everything hurt me. And then from there, I knew that I had to change my life, but I was given the tools and the understanding of the nature of reality in order to do it. So being outside of my life gave me an amazing perspective on life being to me more like a game that we choose to play in order to win, as far as challenges, fears. Like, we're here to develop and grow, to become better people, to treat people better, and not just people, but all life, animals, plants, and the earth. And so our growth equals a change in our soul. So like our soul comes here with a specific signature, and then the goal is to leave this life with that signature slightly altered to the positive. And we get that through struggle, through resistance, through hardship, through experience. Not just all negative, but we also get it through positivity, through happiness. But experience itself is what grows us if we learn. And negative lessons are about learning. And we get the signature change by actually learning from the lesson. Instead of becoming victims, we choose these lessons to grow us, and then we take from it and we become victors, if you will. So there's that. I mean, when I came back for 12 years, it was just work. A lot of the work was just, it was brutal. So coming back to this horrible life again, yes, I had the knowledge and it was great and I'm glad. So I knew what to do, but I still had to suffer. I still had to like go through the shit of the emotions, of what it felt like, of the grief. I mean, God, man, the shame. I had to overcome addiction of all kinds. I had to heal from trauma, PTSD. There's so many things that I had to go through that were horrible. I also ended up homeless, lost everything, including my dog, my house, my girlfriend. It was just a lot of shit that happened after thinking that life, it would be great because you'd have all this knowledge, but it wasn't. It was like putting the knowledge into practice is what actually saved me from the way I was. But I needed that. I needed that lesson. I needed that to happen. That was the most important thing. When you understand your life from a soul level, everything becomes different. Like you start looking at the world from a level that you don't normally look at it from. So we're looking at it from our lives, our jobs, our family, our friends, and everything just kind of comes dilute. It like dilutes from there. But when we start pulling it back to the soul and why we're here and like those bigger perspectives, then life becomes a series of events that make sense. It is pretty interesting stuff. Yes.